So.
We're talking about fruit. Well, there used to be a children's song I thought about doing that one. Because it's a fun song, but it has really nothing to do with fruit here. So, other than we say we're not pineapples and apples and things. So, many of these, you know,
many of you know what all these are, right?
Yeah.
The strawberries, okay. Yep. Apple.
Okay, and they all come from what? Trees and plants, very good. She's safe on that one. All right, yep, they're not all from trees, are they? So,
up there on those pictures, can you tell me which one is which?
Which one goes to, what's the upper left-hand corner? Orange? I believe you are correct.
Yep. Okay. How about the next one below it?
Pineapple.
Yep.
That's what these things are. Do you know all you have to do is
you take this top off and throw it in the ground?
Put it in the ground?
My sister lives in Costa Rica now, and she grows her own pineapples. So every time
she eats one, she sticks that back in the ground and then grows another plant.
So they have like 100.
They have a lot of pineapples.
Okay. The middle one on the bottom.
Yes,
that's what these awesome things are. Those are one of my favorite. Well, I like fruit, so I like all of those things. All right, upper
in the middle.
Apple.
Apple. Good.
And then which tree does that one belong to?
Yeah, the bottom right. Yep. Alexis has these on her. Actually, she grows all of those. I don't know if she grows strawberries, but she grows all of the rest.
Different varieties that are in
Costa Rica as well. But yeah, we know the fruit by their trees or the plants.
I mean, if we stick
a bunch of roots in the ground and we think it's a strawberry and
up comes a raspberry bush, obviously we have the wrong thing. It wasn't what we thought it was.
I mean, that's how you plant strawberries. You get their
roots and you stick them in the ground and then up comes strawberry plants. In less than a year, you might already have something. Apples, I mean, you don't find an apple on a raspberry bush, or you don't find a pineapple on a pear tree. Each fruit has its own sets of roots. And you plant them, and you expect them to grow and produce the fruit that you planted them for. Plants and their fruit don't surprise us. You've never
seen it switch off.
You don't see them change. You don't see them decide, well, today I'm not going to do that. I'm going to do something else. They do what they're supposed to do. In respect of roots and fruit, we have a lot in common with plants, actually.
Because
wherever we stick our roots
is what
we grow. What comes out of us is where we come from, our fruit in our lives. Jesus spoke of fruit quite often in Scripture. What our life is rooted in has a lot to say about who we are and can give us an idea of what we may become, too. Jesus addressed us in the Sermon on the Mount, where the Beatitudes came from. And he was warning the crowds about discerning the truth and true teachers. And he told them that by their fruit you would know who they were and what they were like. He was warning the crowds about discerning the good teachers from the bad ones. And I'd like you to read along with me from Matthew 7, 15 to 20. It says, "Beware of false prophets
who come
disguised as harmless sheep, but are really vicious wolves. You can identify them by their fruit, that is, by the way they act. Can you pick grapes from thorn bushes or figs from thistles? A good tree produces good fruit, and a bad tree produces bad fruit. A good tree can't produce bad fruit, and a bad tree can't produce good fruit. So every tree that does not produce good fruit is chopped down and thrown into the fire. Yes, just as you can identify a tree by its fruit, so you can identify people by their actions." We are to be fruit identifiers. We should see fruit in people's lives and be able to tell if they're following Christ or if they're not. Now in the garden, that's easy. When I plant things, I expect certain things to come up. I mean, when I plant bean seeds, I expect there to be green beans coming up. One year I planted pumpkin or squash and I got pumpkins. Somebody had mixed the seeds up because they're very similar seeds and I didn't tell the difference. And I thought, wow, a lot of pumpkins that year, I had no squash whatsoever. So that is very frustrating because when you plant something, you expect it to be there. Now, if there's something that doesn't
belong in there,
like if it's
a whole row of green beans or in the row of tomatoes, if there's something that
doesn't belong there, even if it's a still, but it still plants itself all over. So when it starts coming up in the green beans, I pull it out because it's not in the right place. It's not where it's supposed to be. It's a weed.